Hi, Seb from Shapr3D here. We've just released a couple of new updates to the Shapr3D application. Shapr3D on desktop now has a context menu. You can right-click anywhere when modeling, drawing, or creating visualizations, and you'll have a number of easy-to-access functions right there at your fingertips. And we've rolled out more granular camera controls for visualization. Let's take a moment to look at how they're working together. Let's start with the context menu. Here we've got a model of a hand wheel, and let's spend some time modeling on that using the new context menu to see how that's working. So we'll add a little keyhole notch to the center here, and we can right-click right here, and you can see one of the new options is very explicitly setting the sketch plane by sketching on the face here. And we can very quickly zoom into that, and I'll hit R on my keyboard to use the rectangle tool. And as you know, we have a number of different rectangle modes, a number of tools have these different modes. And normally you'd access those from the sidebar over here by needing to go there and choose between them. Now with the new context menu, you can also, without needing to go to the other side of the screen, very quickly access those from here. And let's use the rectangle, the center rectangle from here. So we're drawing that out and we've got our sketch defined here. And now we can also very quickly exit sketching so that we can select that face and cut out the necessary keyhole. This is really just the first version of the context menu. We've got a couple of simple interactions related to sketching, relating to zooming out to be able to see the full object really, really quickly. And over the coming year, we're going to be continuing to add existing functions, which we have within Shapr3D to the context menu. And we'll also be constantly adding other features to Shapr3D and always evaluating whether or not they have a place in the context menu. So keep watching that space and expect to see a lot more coming out there. In addition to the context menu, I mentioned we've given much more granular control over the visualization camera settings. Let's take a couple of minutes to look at those now. So you can see here we've got a 3D model of an electric shaver. And let's dive into visualization mode to see how it's working. So the context menu, which I was just talking about, functions here too. And when setting the focus point, the interaction actually already was right-clicking on the point you'd like to use. Now, rather than somewhat implicitly setting that, you actually get this new context point, and you can very explicitly set the focus point. And if you decide you don't want that focus point, you can actually remove the focus point explicitly from here or set a different one. So we've set the focus point here. Let's go back there and set this focus point. And as you can see up here, we've got this new camera tab. And what this does is it gives us control over these three aspects of the camera: the field of view, the aperture, and the blur intensity. We can modify the blur intensity, and we can lower that all the way if we want to. So we've got a super crisp image, or we can go anywhere along the spectrum here and have something that we're really happy with. That's it for today's update. Thanks so much for joining me. As I mentioned, all of these functions are things which we're constantly iterating on. If you have any feedback for us, I'd love to hear it. You can reach out in the comments section. And if there are any things which you'd like to see next, also please reach out. We've got a couple of exciting updates coming up for you soon, a couple of really special ones in the next update video. Tune in next time. See you then.